drawing height we are going to start the disturbance of partial molar properties by the 3 meter. One of them is direct meter, second is from the accurate molar property, and third is from the intercept method. Now out of this method, the direct method, which is not asked in determination, but from accurate molar properties and from intercept method, it is always asked in examination. So direct method is a very important method. Now out of these three methods, we are going to discuss the two methods. One is direct method and second is the determination of partial molar properties from the apparent molar properties. Now we are going to start the first method, and that method is called as the determination of partial molar properties from the direct method. Now in the direct method, as you know, the partial molar property is given by the formula xi bar equals to dou x upon dou ni Tp nO into delta T ni minus 1. This is the formula for the partial molar properties. Now to determine the partial molar properties, a graph is to be plotted. To determine the partial molar properties, the graph is to be plotted between the extensive property x and by keeping constant temperature pressure for various mixture of two components against number of moles. Means we have to plot x against the number of moles. Now by plotting x against the number of moles, we are getting this kind of graph, and to get this kind of graph, we have to make a tangent to this slope. So we are getting s slope, and slope is nothing but the x2 bar. Now the slope of the curve at particular point, is to be determined by trying tangent to the curve, and it gives the value of the x. By keeping, it gives the value of the x. Now if the value of x2 is, if the value of x2 at any composition is to known, then the corresponding value of x1 can be known by using the expression x is equals to m1 x1 bar plus m2 bar. Now this is the direct method. Now the limitation for this method is that this method is not much used, because exact slope in this method cannot be determined or cannot be obtained. So in this, that's why this method is neglected. Now the second method is nothing but the apparent molar property. Now apparent molar property, these are the method which is used for the two component system, and this method is very important method. This is more frequently used method, because result in this method are very accurate, results are going to obtain in this method. Now apparent molar property is frequently used to study the thermodynamic properties of the system of the two component. Two component system is the thermodynamic property determined by the apparent molar property is frequently used. Now suppose x. X is the value of particular property. For the mixture n1 moles of constituent 1 and n2 moles of constituent 2. Now x1 is the value of property of constituent 1. X1 ka hai, it is the value of property of the constituent 1, of the pure substance of the constituent 1. Now apparent molar property is given by the formula identity of the x by x. Apparent molar property is denoted by the phi x. Now phi x is equal to x minus n1 x1 upon n2. It is a circle, here are determined. After the mighty x is equal to n1 x1 bar plus n2 bar. Therefore, x minus n1 x1 bar is equal to n plus 2 bar. Therefore, x2 bar is equal to x minus n1 x1 bar 1 divided by n2. And this is nothing but the multiply by this. We are getting the expression x minus n1 x1 is equal to n2 phi x. Is equal to n2 phi x. Just for some reason. Now, differentiate equation 2. By keeping temperature, pressure and n1 constant. I tell you, differentiate equation 2 like that. Because the temperature, pressure and number of moles n1 are constant. Now here we are getting the dou s upon dou n2. So what is the differentiate equation? That is why n1 is constant, energy value is not 0. So this term is given. So dou s upon dou n2. Because we are differentiating this equation to n2. Dou x upon dou n2 by keeping n1 out of bracket is equals to n2 l. At the bottom of the first function integrated of second function. One first function n2 integrated of second function 5. Dou phi x upon dou n2 by keeping n1 constant plus second function integrated of first function. This is the one I have already said. At the time,
as I get to the m with respect to m2, derivative that becomes the 1. So only phi x, we are getting the equation number 3. Now, equation number 3 we can return like this key, dou x upon dou m2 we can write x2 bar. x2 bar is equal to dou phi x upon dou m2 phi x. त्या ठिकाणी वस्तू बार लिहितो आणि या ठिकाणी dlnn2 म्हणजे dlnn2 म्हणजे काय दिसत फॉर डिफरेन्शिएशन dlnn2 इज इक्वल टू dn2 बाय n2 आणि यू कॅन रिवर्स इट 1 अपॉन dlnn2 इज इक्वल टू n2 बाय dn2 बरोबर आहे. इफ यू आर पुटिंग देयर वी आर गेटिंग द एक्सप्रेशन k2 बार इज इक्वल टू dou phi x अपॉन dou lnn2 n1 प्लस phi x इक्वेशन नंबर 4. आता त्या ठिकाणी n2 च्या जागी घ्यायचं m, सिन्स वॉल्यूम इज इक्वल टू m2 n2 च्या जागी घ्यायचं m ठेवायचं बाय चिपिंग n1 कॉन्स्टंट. सो इक्वेशन 3 बिकम्स व्हाट इज इक्वेशन 3 बिकम्स इक्वेशन 3 बिकम्स काय होणार त्या ठिकाणी n2 च्या जागी आपण काय ठेवणार आहोत m ठेवणार आहोत म्हणून x2 बार म्हणून काय झालं त्या ठिकाणी इक्वेशन 4 मध्ये काय झालं x2 बार इक्वेशन 3 काय झालं x2 बार इज इक्वल टू m डो y अपॉन डो डो m n1 कारण की आपण काय करतो n2 ला जी m 2 लावतो प्लस फाय इक्वेशन 5. आता इक्वेशन 4 मध्ये काय ठेवतो आपण एल एम टू बरोबर आपण एम ठेवणार आहोत मग इक्वेशन 4 काय आता इक्वेशन 4 एक्स टू बार इज इक्वल टू डो फाय एक्स डो एल एन एम एल 1 प्लस फाय इक्वेशन 6. नाउ इन दिस वे वी आर गोइंग टू डिटरमाइन द पार्शियल मोलर प्रॉपर्टीज मला एक्स टू बार म्हणजे काय एक्स टू बार म्हणजे हियर वी आर गोइंग टू डिटरमाइन द पार्शियल मोलर प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द कंपोनेंट 2. Now in this case, remember here, या केस मध्ये काय करते की पार्शियल मोलर प्रॉपर्टीज या ठिकाणी वी हॅव टू प्लॉट अ ग्राफ आणि कसं करणार प्लॉट फाय एक्स अगेन्स्ट एम टू ऑर एम टू म्हणजे एम ऑर फाय एक्स अगेन्स्ट एन लॉग एम टू ऑर लॉग एम एम ऑर लॉग एम या प्रकारे आपण करू शकतो. आणि बघा या ठिकाणी मोस्ट काय इक्वेशन नंबर 3 आणि 4 3 आणि 5 it give most accurate results. What it gives? It gives most accurate result. That's why equation number 3 and 5 they are frequently used. The equation number 4 and 6 they are not used. Why it is not used? Because it is not giving the accurate result. When it is not giving the accurate result? When the solutions are used in the dilute concentration. Right? So in this way, apparent molar properties can be determined. Now these are the three methods to determine the partial molar properties. Out of each, we have seen the direct method and second method is from the apparent molar properties. Right? So you have to see video daily, right? And learn daily. Okay? Well, thank you very much. We are waiting the next lecture to start with the third method of determination of partial molar properties from the intercept method. Thank you very much.